What's up, everybody? It's Alex from Heavy New York, invading California for Namm 2020. We are here with Timo of Delain. Thank you so much for your time.
Thank you for having me, man.
Yeah. It's so awesome to have you here. We're here right now at your guitar booth. You want to talk about, Aristides guitar and everything like that?
Yeah, so it's Aristides guitars. It's based from Harlem, the Netherlands. We build composite, well, not me. I don't specifically build, I know we go on. But they build guitars from composite material called Arium. The idea is it's way more stable. You know, I noticed that touring and recording, it's this most stable guitar I've ever had. We have all these models, 6-string, 7-string, 8-string, you know, and this is the best guitars, you know, that's all.
You know, playing with Delain, do you feel like that this is the gear that best suits the style of metal that you play, or is it just the guitar you've always worked with that's the most comfortable using?
It's both. Like, I started playing it because I, as a guitar player, liked it and loved the sound, right? But then it also had to work in Delain. So if that wouldn't be the case, I wouldn't use it in Delain, you know what I mean? Because that the priority is that it sounds good in the project or band that you're playing in, right? So it's both. Like, I love the feel, I love the sound. Delain loved the feel and loved the sound of it, our sound guy, you know? So I took it in Delain, and it's perfect. But it's way more versatile than just one genre, you know?
Yeah. In terms of your like guitar playing style for your solos and all this, like, are you like working off of a theoretical element? Like, I have to work off of this scale and this chord progression, or is like the music rather improvised?
Like, I'm like 90% improvised. Like, I know very little, theory. During the years, I kind of know it now, you know what I mean? But like, I never think of theory, you know, it's all improvisation. All the solos, usually I just start improvising and then, you know, end up with something that sounds written, but it's really improvised and took from there, right? I'm really a non-theory guy, for sure, okay. For sure.
Yeah, sometimes theory can, like, enslave you too much, right?
A little bit, like, and I noticed some, like, theory or technical or, like, skills, when you get too stuck in it, you know, you get too stuck in it, right? So usually, sometimes I'm better when I didn't play for, like, 1 or 2 days, you know what I mean? Because it opens your mind up a little bit more. So, but everything has its up and downsides, right? Because knowing theory is easy if you're like more into jazz or like have to work with other people really quickly and you want to communicate. But for me, it really works doing the improvisation. I train my ear, so I'm cool with doing that, you know. And I can sit with players that do know theory, you know what I mean? Like, I can fake my way through that. So yeah, it's all good.
Now, obviously, you know, we talked about your guitar body and everything and like that, but, you know, strings, guitars, amps, pickups, I mean, like, you want to give, like, a full rundown of the arsenal?
Yeah, man, sure. So, RC's guitars for everything, then I use Dunlop picks, mostly thick ones, like 3 millimeter. Then I just switched to Ernie Ball strings. Yeah, I break strings really easily because I have quite a heavy bending style because I'm more of a blues rock guy than a metal guy by origin, right? So I switched to Ernie Ball Paradigm strings. I love those. Then most of my guitars have the Fishman Fluence pickups that I absolutely love. My main 8-string with Delain has bare knuckle pickups because Fishman doesn't do the slanted fret set. So then amp-wise, in the studio I use a Rev Generator 120. It's an amazing Canadian amp company, really forward-thinking amp company. Sound amazing. Live, I use their D20 amp, which is it's only 4 kilos. I use their G3 distortion pedal with it. I have 2, so I'm stereo with Delain because we had 2 guitar players and now I'm back to 1, right? So I have a stereo setup. 2 amps fit in like a 20 kilo travel case, so that's amazing. So the D20, what's left? It goes straight into the PA. Pedals really differ, you know. I'm mostly a straight in the amp guy, but the Rev distortion pedals are amazing, and I'll just use whatever it needs, you know, for the project. And I think that should be it. Yeah, I have a lot of things that I love, but that's the main ingredients.
You mentioned you switched to Ernie Balls. What gauge are you using?
So usually when I'm in E standard, I'll use 10 to 52 because I like the heavy bottom. For 7-string, I use 10 to 52 with a loose 65 usually. An 8-string is 80 on the lowest one, 62 on the 7-string, and then 10 to 52 again.
Because yeah. I've noticed, like, you know, you're using multiple styles, but like Delain's music, you know, you have like some stuff off of April Rain that's very melodic, yeah. But then you have stuff like off Moonbathers, very heavy. So like, I'd imagine you have to switch and adjust your guitar tone quite frequently when you're playing live, right?
The funny thing is that it kind of sounds like that, but I mainly use just two guitar sounds the whole show.
Really?
Yeah, so the more the subtleties come into how to play it and the actual parts, you know what I mean? But the sound is pretty consistent. Like, it's just a really tight, high gain sound. And for leads, I just boost that sound, add delays and reverbs. But like, the records sound very different, but guitar sound wise, it's actually pretty consistent throughout all the records. Yeah.
That must make a roadie's life 10 times easier.
It is, and for me too. Like, I don't like switching through 15 million sounds, you know. It's cool if your band really is about that, but delaying, like, I think the difference comes between the actual parts and the melodies and the arrangements, but all the sounds are pretty consistent. Yeah.
And I just wanted to ask one question for your ability to write music with your guitar. Like, do you get inspired like out of nowhere? Do you like come up with a riff or a chord progression just out of nowhere sometimes? Or do you have to like put yourself in a certain element in order to get an idea to bring to the band?
Yeah, pretty much both, you know? So sometimes I'm just sitting on the couch and suddenly like a melody strikes me. And, you know, I'll record it on my phone real quick and I go in my studio and record it. Other times when I, you know, need to write something, I'll just sit down. But it's always from inspiration. I can like bring up inspiration, you know what I mean? If I don't have it immediately, I'll just play my guitar, see what kind of vibe I come up with, and then go from there. So like in my playing, I'm kind of an improviser, but with writing as well, kind of, you know, I just go somewhere and then if I like it, I'll build it further, you know? So that's it.
So I want to thank you so much for your time today. Is there just anything else with Aristide's guitar that you'd like to promote?
I mean, check them out. We have a new Telecaster for like Telecaster model for people that are like a little more vintage or a little more specifically Tellies. So check that out. I mean, to me, I love the guitar so much. And you kind of have to hear it to believe it. The stability and the sound, it's top notch. So just check it out, man. Awesome. Yeah.
Well, Timo, thank you so much.
Thank you.
Timo of Delain, everybody. Namm 2020.